Greetings and welcome. In this video session, we will discuss about experiment, that is determination of viscosity of engine oil by Redwood viscometer. In this session, we will discuss about theory of viscosity, construction of Redwood viscometer, experimental procedure, observations and sample calculations, results and discussion, and practical relevance. Let us discuss about viscosity theory.
Hello everyone, dear students. In today's session, in a lab session, we are going to see experiment number 2, that is determination of viscosity of liquid using Redwood viscometer. So here there are two types of substances. Okay, in a fluid mechanics, by the definition, fluid is a what? Either liquid or gas. So definitely this property, that is a viscosity property, that is applicable for both, that is gas or liquid. But for measurement of gas, okay, measurement of gas viscosity, the setup or equipment, that is a different. The Redwood viscometer, which we are going to discuss today, or we are going to see in a practical, that Redwood viscometer is only manufactured for measurement of viscosity of oil only, that is liquid. So generally this oil we use in an engine for the lubrication purpose. So in a brief, we will see what is the viscosity. So viscosity is what? Internal resistance offered by the liquid to its flow. When the fluid is flowing through, for example, pipe, so this is a pipe surface. So we find this kind of scenario. Pipe flow. So this liquid flow is in the form of layers. One layer, two layer, three layer, in this way these layers are forming. So these number of layers are flowing. So definitely here what happens, the central layer velocity we find maximum, means layer at the center of the fluid flow is flowing with maximum velocity. As the distance from the center towards the surface of the pipe we go, that velocity of that layer is decreasing, and at the surface, at both these surfaces, here the velocity of the fluid is ideally zero. This happens because the fluid has property called as viscosity. Now this fluid particles are at the surface at stationary condition. Fluid particles are stationary. This condition is called as no slip condition. No slip condition means fluid particles are sticking. They have stick. Okay, they have stuck to this boundary, and that's why here we find velocity zero. So if you want profile, then we find this profile in this way. This profile we call as velocity profile. Profile means what? A representation of variation of velocity with respect to distance. At the periphery or at the surface, velocity zero. As the distance of layer from the surface increases, velocity increases. At the center, it reaches to maximum value. So, this curve is called as velocity profile, and it is parabolic in nature because the shape of this curve, which I have shown here, that is like a parabola. That's why we say this kind of velocity profile as a parabolic velocity profile. Okay. Now, to know the viscosity, now what we are using, that is also we are using like a pipe. We are passing this fluid oil through a small cylindrical part, cylindrical tube. That is a part of redwood viscometer. Okay, and its dimension means its geometry. That oil is passing through the tube, small tube. Its diameter, suppose, is a capital D. The oil in the redwood viscometer, which is passing, this is called as orifice tube. Length of this tube is capital L, and diameter of this orifice is D. And oil which is flowing through this tube, that is flowing with some velocity V. Okay, this oil will have the property which is here responsible for decreasing the velocity, that is viscosity, and that is again dynamic viscosity. Along with dynamic viscosity, there is one more property that already we take in discussion, that is what density. Okay. Now, its construction or manufacturing, that manufacturing is done. For that dimensions, one formula is developed. Okay. That formula is used to find the viscosity. Now, in this experiment, we are not using dynamic viscosity formula. We are going to use kinematic viscosity formula. Why? The reason you will find, okay, in the coming discussion. So, this viscosity which leads to retard the flow velocity, this viscosity is because of cohesion. Okay, there are two cases. One is a cohesion and another is molecular activity is taking place in the fluid. Any fluid which is there, intermolecular activity means bonding among the molecule. That is called as intermolecular attraction. Okay. This activity is going when the fluid is present in the pipe or on the plate, it is flowing. This activity is going on. So we will see that here in case of liquid, viscosity is due to cohesion. Okay, cohesion means what? Cohesion means, suppose this is a molecule. See it? This molecule and another molecule. So in this way, there will be number of molecules in the liquid. So there will be bonding among these molecules, force of attraction. This is called as cohesion. Another case is intermolecular momentum transfer. This is a part in a liquid, and intermolecular momentum exchange, that part in a gases. Okay. Now, when the fluid is flowing, then it is flowing in the form of layers. So here, this layer and this layer, they have surface in a contact. So here, shear force, the force acting on this plane to move, that is called a shear force. And the area which is in a contact. This shear force and this area ratio, that is called as shear stress. So this shear stress is a responsible. Okay, this shear stress is a responsible to retard the flow, because it is one kind of opposition to the flow. So in case of liquid, effect of temperature, in case of liquid, when the liquid is heated, temperature of liquid increases. When the temperature of liquid increases, then cohesion among the molecule decreases. When the cohesion among the molecule decreases, then shear stress which is there, that decreases, means opposition to the flow decreases. So in case of liquid, when the temperature increases, viscosity decreases, means fluid becomes thin, it flows easily in case of liquid. With increase of temperature, viscosity in a liquid decreases. But in case of gases, here this gas is flowing, by the application of heat, there molecular momentum transfer occurs. Momentum, okay, this momentum transfer is taking place across the flow in this way. This is what momentum exchange among the molecule. This activity is taking place normal to the flow direction. This is a flow direction, and momentum exchange, that is taking place normal, means perpendicular. Means in this case, it acts as an obstacle. It offers resistance. So that is why in gases, with increase of temperature, this momentum transfer activity increases. Thus, it increases shear stress also, increases shear stress, and finally, that is why here in this case, viscosity increases, and thus, means in case of liquid and in case of gas, the scenario is different. In case of liquid, viscosity decreases because decrease in cohesion, bonding, oil becomes thin. In case of gas, momentum transfer, which is taking across the flow, that is why it acts as an obstacle. It offers resistance, increases shear stress, ultimately viscosity increases. Now, to know absolute viscosity mathematically, there are two types of viscosity. One is a dynamic viscosity and other one is a kinematic viscosity. So here, to know about absolute viscosity, there is a law, that is Newton's law of viscosity. And to know that Newton's law of viscosity, here we have some discussion that we take two plates because this law is applicable for particular case only. This Newton's law of viscosity is not valid for all cases. So for that, this is a case what we are taking. So this is a plate, fixed plate, lower plate. This is a stationary or fixed plate. Means this plate has zero velocity. Okay, and this upper plate is a moving plate. This plate is moving with velocity, maximum velocity, that is u. Okay, and the fluid which is present here, okay, this fluid is stationary fluid, not moving fluid. Now, as I said that here, at this point, because of stickiness or cohesion, cohesive property of the fluid, fluid particle at this point, that viscosity is zero. And as distance from this lower plate increases, that distance we will take as a y, capital Y. This distance increases, the flow velocity of these layers increases. Okay, so suppose there is a layer which is flowing with small u velocity, upper layer is moving with velocity u plus du. Okay, so distance between these two layers that we consider as a dy, and difference between these two velocities, that is du. Lower layer with u velocity, higher layer with u plus du velocity. So here the ratio, that is du upon dy, this is called as velocity gradient. Velocity gradient. So by Newton's law of viscosity, here the shear stress which is present in the layers, that is directly proportional to velocity gradient. And mathematically we write this tau is equal to mu into du upon dy. This is a formula, or this is a law which is called as Newton's law of viscosity. But this is only valid when velocity and distance between the plates is not great. Great means large. For smaller distance and for low velocity. In case of low velocity of the fluid and in case of smaller distance between the two layer, this Newton's law of viscosity is applicable. Okay. Now, the second type of viscosity, that is kinematic viscosity. Kinematic viscosity. That kinematic viscosity is indicated by Greek symbol, that is called as nu, N-U-E, which is ratio of dynamic viscosity to rho. It is pronounced as M-U-E, M-U-E, mu, dynamic viscosity. Kinematic viscosity is pronounced as N-U-E, nu. See, these both are Greek symbols. These both are Greek symbols. Okay. Now, as far as mu is concerned, already that law, what we have, shear stress is equal to, we had this equation. We will to this point, okay, after the discussion on the units. Okay, so this shear stress is a what, force upon area. Okay, this is a mu and this is d upon dy. So what we will do, we will write this in this form, mu is equal to shear stress, that is force upon area, divided by du upon dy. I have written this, why? Because now we will learn how to produce unit. Okay, force is measured in meters, newton, area is measured in meter square, newton per meter square, divided by du, that is a change in velocity. Velocity is measured in meter per second. Dy, that is a distance between the two layers, that is measured in meter. Now we have to simplify this. To simplify this, what we will do? Newton per meter square into. We will write this in this way. Meter upon meter per second. How it happened? How it came here? In the mathematics, I am showing here in the shaded area or covered area, that if we have 1/1 x in the mathematics, for example, then it is x. Likewise here, 1/this quantity, that can be m/s. In this case, here cancellation of terms will be there. Okay, so you can cancel this m, or you can cancel this meter with this meter. Okay, so here newton, this is again 1/1 s. As per this mathematics law, it will come here newton second. Okay, and this meter square which is present here will come here. So unit of dynamic viscosity, that is newton second per meter square. This is SI unit. This is SI unit. Okay, now we use here smaller unit for commercial purpose. For commercial purpose, we use smaller unit. That is what? Poise. That is a poise. Now this poise is what actually? It is CGS unit. This is SI unit. It's CGS unit for the newton. We take force in a dime in CGS unit. For time, second unit as it is. For length, centimeter. So this dime second per centimeter square, dime second per centimeter square, this CGS unit, okay, this is called as poise. And this poise is used as a commercial unit in the industry. Now there is a relation between this SI unit and commercial unit. So here, that is 1 newton second per meter square is equal to 10 poise conversion. Okay, so especially you can remember in this way, that commercial unit, in that value increases. Okay, value in the SI unit, if we convert, in case of commercial unit, value increases. 1 newton second per meter square, value is what, 10, that is increasing. In that way you can remember, because in the numerical, most of the times in the numerical, viscosity is mentioned in poise. So in that case, you have to convert that viscosity in newton second per meter square. So there question or confusion comes in your mind, either to multiply or divide by 10. So we were about to discuss again about kinematic viscosity. That kinematic viscosity is what? Nu is equal to mu upon rho. Now here there is no apparatus to measure the dynamic viscosity. Okay, we can measure density, but it is difficult to measure dynamic viscosity because dynamic viscosity has a formula in which force comes. So to measure the force, the arrangement, that apparatus becomes very critical to manufacture. But to measure the kinematic viscosity by using apparatus is easy, because in a kinematic viscosity, if you see unit, then you see about its unit. Newton second per meter square is a unit of dynamic viscosity. Unit of rho is a kg per meter cube. Newton is again product of mass into acceleration. Mass unit kg, acceleration unit is meter per second square. So we will write here kg meter per second square for the Newton. So kg meter per second square, okay, into this is 1 upon meter square. Take care while writing Newton kg meter per second square, this quantity, okay, into s into 1 by meter square. This is a kg per meter cube. Now in this case we will have now simplification. Kg meter second divided by second square into 1 upon meter square into meter cube by kg. All the parameters we have written in a simplified manner. Now here the things which will be cancelled, that we will see, this kilogram cancelled, this second cancelled with square, this meter square will cancel with this meter cube and will remain here meter. What I am saying, this meter square is cancelling with meter cube, will remain only one m, one dimension. So here this m which is, and this m, this both will have product, that's why meter square, and here one s is remaining, that is what, second. Means SI unit of kinematic viscosity is meter square per second. Okay, similarly if you write CGS unit, what will be CGS unit? Centimeter square per second. Okay, now by the observation, see, by the observation you can learn, as kinematic viscosity is here as a function of what? Two elements. One is a dimension, other is a time. But mu is a function of force, time and dimension. Dimension will be geometry of the setup, time will be oil flow, and this will be force. So for which condition or for which type it is easy to manufacture the device of viscosity measurement? This or this? Because here is a dimension and a time. So if we vary the time, or we can measure the time of oil flow by using what? Stopwatch. And dimension, it is in our hand when we are going to design the apparatus. So that is why we prefer kinematic viscosity measurement. And for that we will use Redwood viscometer. Okay, now in this case here, likewise dynamic viscosity, here again is a commercial unit that used. That unit is what? This centimeter square per second. It is also called as Stoke. This is also called as Stoke. Okay, and there is a relation that we need for the conversion. Okay, so that conversion is what? One Stoke means 1 centimeter square per second. that is equal to 10 raised to minus 4 meter square per second. This you remember. After the kinematic viscosity, now to go for the manufacturing concept or about the construction of redwood viscometer, we have to consider here one concept. That is what? The flow which is here of oil. In this case, in a kinematic viscosity measurement or in redwood viscometer, this flow is laminar, because redwood viscometer works on the principle of laminar flow. Redwood viscometer work based on laminar flow principle. Laminar flow means what? When the flow is taking place, then all the layers are flowing parallel to each other. These layers are not intersecting. But for that, the condition is what? Velocity of the fluid flow should be small. Okay, that is very important. If the velocity is higher, then definitely these flow layers are mixing. That flow is called as turbulent flow. Turbulence is a word we use in a internal combustion engine, IC engine. Okay, here the case is what? Laminar flow. So fluid layers are parallel. Such flow is called as laminar flow. Now, in this case, when the flow is taking place, because of viscosity, there is a friction. Okay, there is a reduction in a pressure. Okay, in a flow, because of viscous nature, we call it as viscosity. Viscosity, its word viscous. The fluid or oil, we say viscous is in nature. Non-viscous is in nature means very low viscosity. Water, it has low viscosity. Oil has more viscosity. Oil is more viscous in a nature, in that way. So in a flow, because of viscous nature of oil, there is pressure drop occurs. Okay, this pressure drop is measured by using equation that is called as Hagen-Poiseuille equation. This pressure drop is measured by using principle or equation Hagen, POISUILLE, Hagen-Poiseuille equation. Here Hagen-Poiseuille equation. See, that equation is given, P1 minus P2 is a pressure drop. See, P1 is a pressure at one location, P2 is a pressure at a next location in the oil flow. So P1 minus P2 is a pressure drop, pressure difference. That is equal to formula 32 times mu means dynamic viscosity. V means velocity of oil flow. L is a length between that pressure drop occurs, divided by d square. D square means diameter of the pipe through which that flow is taking place. Okay, so we will elaborate here mu is a dynamic viscosity of oil, v is a velocity of oil, and length between the points, between two points, one and points 1 and 2. That's why here P1 minus P2 we have taken. And D is a diameter, diameter of pipe through which this oil is flowing. Okay. Now what we do, we need pressure drop. This pressure drop is in Newton per meter square. The pressure drop which is present here, equation, that is in the Pascal. Pascal Newton per meter square. Here we need this pressure drop in a meter. Meter column. We know that rho g h. Formula of pressure. Rho into g into h. Where h is a height of liquid column which we use to measure the pressure. So in that form we have to bring this equation. So for that purpose, what we would do, what we divide this above equation, write down here, divide the equation by specific weight of oil, specific weight of oil. Okay, means P1 minus P2 divided by gamma. Gamma is a notation, Greek symbol for the specific weight of oil, is equal to 32 mu VL by gamma D square. This P1 minus P2 by gamma, this is called as what? Head. This comes in meter now. So that is why further H is equal to 32 mu VL by gamma D square. Okay. Now this comes in meter, height H, that is comes in meter. So now we will continue with this equation. In this equation, this mu and gamma, these values or these parameters we will change. How? See, this gamma is rho g. We know specific weight is a product of density into gravity. Okay, so for the gamma now we will write this rho g. So h is equal to 32 mu v l upon rho g d square. Now see here, this mu upon rho, already we have seen, this is what mu upon rho is, kinematic viscosity. So further h will be equal to 32 nu. Now nu will come for the v, mu upon rho, nu will come v into l gd square. Okay. Now next, see, we have one equation, q is equal to area into velocity, that is called a discharge. So velocity can be written as q by a. In this equation, this v we will replace by q upon a. Okay. then this Q is again volume upon time. Q is a discharge, it is meter cube per second, its unit is meter cube per second. Now we will again modify this equation. So H is equal to 32 kinematic viscosity, here volume, L means length, divided by GD square, area, and here time will come. Now in this case, here area is, now this area we will take that what we had in earlier discussion. Now we will come to the point, you will understand now. We started our discussion with this orifice tube. This tube has this diameter capital D and this length. So this tube cross-sectional area is circular. So area of this pi by 4 into D square, pi r square we can use, but as we are using here D diameter, that's why we have to use area in pi by 4 D square format. So this pi by 4 D square we will use here. Okay, so next to this 32 kinematic viscosity, volume, length, divided by GD square, here pi by 4 D square into time. Okay, now see, this is a 4, that is 1 divided by 1 divided by 4. This 4 will come here at the numerator in the next step. So it will become 32 multiplied by 4 into kinematic viscosity, into volume, into length, divided by G into pi, this D square and this D square, D raised to 4 time. Okay, so here 32 multiplied by 4, 128. 128 times kinematic viscosity into volume into length divided by pi into G D raised to 4 into time. So H is equal to, we got the relation, 120 times new volume L upon pi G D raised to 4 time. Okay, so what we do, that equation what we had now, that equation we will write in the form of nu, because our interest to find kinematic viscosity. So for kinematic viscosity, now the equation will become pi into H G D raised to 4 time divided by 128 volume into length. Okay, so now in this case, see here, all the parameters that we have here, I am doing here, all the parameters which I have covered with the boundary line, all these parameters are regarding either with constant, either they are a constant or they are a part of setup, Redwood viscometer, pi, constant value, H, that is a pressure drop which occurs, okay, G, acceleration due to gravity, D, diameter of that device, 128, number, volume, this volume we are using 50 ml by the Redwood viscometer, or Redwood, who invented this Redwood viscometer, he conducted trials. In the trial he used volume of collection of oil 50 ml. So 50 ml oil volume is fixed. length, that is the height of that tube. And this h is what, how much height, h is the height of oil. In the tube which is present in the setup, in that the height of oil that we are measuring, not measuring, we are maintaining. How? So I will show here in the diagram, in the further diagram, we will come to the point that. Okay, so what I mean to say, all these points, these we will take as a one constant or one as value. That value is a calculated value. So by considering all parameters above as a constant value, say that value as alpha, letter alpha, I am writing here alpha. Kinematic viscosity equation comes alpha into time. Now here kinematic viscosity equation becomes only function of time. So this time is what? Time required to collect 50 ml of oil. Okay, I am writing here. This time is time required to collect 50 ml oil or liquid. So here only unknown is what? Kinematic viscosity. Time we are going to measure for the collection of 50 ml pass oil which is passing, we are passing through that orifice tube. Through this we are passing the oil. So for this flow we will have here one flask that we call as a measuring flask that we will keep below this. On this flask there will be marking, and highest maximum marking level will be of 50 ml. So we will start stopwatch, we will start that timer in a mobile, and will allow to fall oil in this flask. When this oil will reach to this 50 ml mark, at that time we will stop the timer. So that will be what, time of 50 ml collection of oil here in a second. Okay, and alpha is a geometrical constant. This is a geometrical constant, geometry constant. How much diameter, how much length, how much h is decided by the Redwood viscometer in the construction. All these parameters are regarding with geometry. So for that Redwood viscometer provides us constant alpha value. But in this case when we are doing experiment, okay, there is some error. That error comes in the measurement. So that error, why? Because when the oil is flowing, here friction is taking place, pressure drop is taking place. Okay, so their correct value of this kinematic viscosity is not getting. So for that purpose we are adding one more constant, that is called as correction factor. So here we add kinematic viscosity is equal to alpha t minus beta upon t. T we use for the time. Henceforth in the expression we will use this t for time. So this beta we use as a correction factor. Correction factor. Now alpha and beta are the values provided by Redwood viscometer. So alpha is 0.0026 and beta is 1.72. Okay, so now the formula for the experiment conduction we use, that is kinematic viscosity is equal to 0.026 times time minus 1.72 divided by time. This formula we use in the experiment. Okay, now we will have construction. Now based on that all the parameters, now the construction of viscometer. Is done. Okay, what is that construction? See, that apparatus is kept on the table. On the table, there is one tripod. Tripod means three legs. And here, arrangement is for the leveling. These are leveling screws. By rotating these leveling screws, this tripod is adjusted in a such way that apparatus which is above this, this will remain in vertical position. Okay, so this apparatus consists of this outer big pan. Okay, in that pan there is again cup shape. Device. Bottom of this device has that hole, small hole, and here what we, that is what orifice tube is a present here. Orifice tube. Okay. Here the oil is filled. Now this oil is filled up to the height which we have discussed in the derivation formula. To maintain this height, by the Redwood viscometer identified the height, and here this oil level indicator is provided. So fill the oil up to this oil level indicator. Okay, up to this point oil is filled. Then this side, in the side pan, here water is provided. Water. Okay. Now here in this application of heater coil. So heater coil is provided for heating the oil. This is a heater coil. And here electrical connection is given. So this is called as water bath. Temperature of water is increased. Thus it will heat the oil. And here oil temperature will increase. So this is called as oil bath. Water bath and oil bath. Okay. Now in this case, to have uniform temperature, here stirrer is provided. Stirrer. While doing the experiment, slowly this stirrer is to be moved. That will maintain the temperature constant or uniform in the water bath. Thus, oil will be heated uniformly. Okay, now this oil flow, we have to start to measure the oil in the measuring flask that already we have discussed. So for that purpose, here is a ball valve. Okay, I will show here. This is a ball, steel ball. It is kept here. When it is kept, hole will be closed. Okay. Whenever we want to measure the oil, means at a particular temperature, we have to lift this wall. Means by holding this, we can just lift, oil flow will start. Oil flow starts, then we, by using timer for 50 ml, we measure the time. This is what construction of Redwood viscometer.
Let us discuss about Redwood viscometer experiment procedure.
This is a Redwood viscometer. Okay. As per the discussion, these are the three leveling screws. This is a body. This is a water bath. Here you can see upper. Here is a coil, that is a heater. This inner portion, cup portion, where the oil is filled. This is the oil what we use to measure this oil quantity in a mm. Here are the two flasks.
Here is shown 50 ml oil. By this we measure the oil and we feel here inside this. Here is an index mark. Here is an index mark like this. Up to that position we feel the cup. After that this is an electrical heater connection given. This electrical heater connection is given through this energy regulator. Energy regulator is used to increase the current. However, we will move this knob. At that way, electrical current will be increased. Okay, so this is for the heating purpose of the oil. Another case, this is a thermometer. Okay, electrical thermometer. Now this thermometer is giving the reading. Atmospheric temperature we have taken 30, that is 29.88, means equivalent to 30 degree. This 30 degree temperature is initially of the oil without heating when we are using air. So for that purpose we are dipping this probe. Then for this we are measuring the reading of oil. Okay, by using this flask, there is one more flask of a smaller capacity, that this 50 ml capacity, that we keep here and we open that aperture and we measure the flow and time for 50 ml volume. Then after that the same oil which is being collected, again we refill here. Refill, again we maintain the level. Then we start the heater. Starting the heater, then we measure the temperature up to 40 degree. When the temperature of this oil is reaching to 40 degree, then we allow oil to fall in this flask. For the 50 ml measurement, we measure the time. So in this way, we repeat the procedure of experiment for 30 degree, 40 degree, 50 degree, 60, 70, 80 degree. For the all readings, we got the time in a second in your mobile. And these all values we put in the observation table and accordingly we have seen how to do calculation. Okay, so this was about the Redwood viscometer, apparatus and conduction, methodology of the experiment. Understood?
Now let us see observations and calculations.
So we use observation table in that 5 to 6 readings we take. First is a serial number column, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, whatever readings we have to take, we enter in this table. Okay. Second column is of temperature of oil. So in that we are using three columns. First is the initial temperature. Second is the final temperature and third is the average temperature. When we are starting the experiment initially, suppose this is a today's temperature, average temperature. This is a temperature without heating. So in the both initial and final, temperature is not changing. So 30-30, at this 30 we are conducting the test and we are measuring the time. So this time in a second you can enter over here. Suppose for this test initially it takes lot of time in a second. As an example I have written the values. Okay, then we follow the experiment for further readings by heating. Second reading we start the heater, we wait to reach the oil temperature at average temperature 40, means suppose that water is reached to 38, at that time we stop the heater. Automatically we will get that temperature is increased up to 42, for example, then its average comes 40. In this way, for the second reading again we lift the ball valve, measure the time for 50 ml and that we write here. Suppose that time has been come here 346. In this way every temperature, say 50, 60, 70, 80, for these number of different temperatures we follow the same procedure, we find the time. For example, we got these values, these are the values of time, and then By using the formula kinematic viscosity 0.026 times T minus 1.72 divided by time. By using this formula, here is only what? Variable time. So for each time, we can calculate kinematic viscosity and we can write here in the last column. This can be separate further as a result table. This part is a observation table. When we add last column, that becomes result table. Okay, so here kinematic viscosity by the formula that we find, for example, here by the calculation, these are the values we have got. From this, we see that initially kinematic viscosity value is higher at low temperature, means ambient temperature. As the temperature is increased, kinematic viscosity value is decreased, means viscosity of the oil decreases with temperature. Because why? Cohesion among the molecule decreases with temperature. Now here we can have here graph for this. This graph, on this you take here y for the kinematic viscosity in a stoke, y axis, and this horizontal axis x you take for the temperature value. So scale is suppose 0, 10, 20, 30, like this. Okay, and here are the values of kinematic viscosity, say 0.2, 0.4, like this. Scale will be as per the values range available or we have obtained. These values are in a stoke on a y-axis. Okay, so initially we have got that value 2.44 at the temperature of 30. Here we are getting this first point. Second value is 0.9 here for the temperature, average temperature here. This is the second point. Then 0.8 at the 50, then 0.6 at the temperature 60, and 0.54 at 70, and finally 0.39 at the 40. Okay, so we get here curve or graph by joining these points. Okay, now here in this observation we find that in early, between two readings, there is a drastic or large fall in a kinematic viscosity with respect to change in temperature. So there is a ratio, viscosity index, that is a ratio, or that is a temperature kinematic viscosity change, kinematic viscosity change with respect to temperature change. What I mean to say, there is a viscosity index, this is a mathematic, actually there is no direct relation, Vi is equal to change in kinetic, there is actually somewhere other formula, but this is general definition, Vi. So what happens here, if you see the here, large change in a viscosity for small change in a temperature. So this oil is a sensitive oil. In this, and here if you see here, change in a viscosity is a small. That's why here we find less sensitive oil. See, as far as viscosity index is concerned, there are three categories. of the oil. Okay, the oil which is here, that is low sensitive oil, low VI oil. This is medium, and this is high VI. See, when the slope of the line is not steep, it is a flat, means there is a small change in a viscosity with respect to temperature. Such oil is preferred for the heavy duty. High viscosity oil is preferred for heavy duty applications. Where the kinematic viscosity change is higher for small temperature change, these are preferred for low duty applications. Now, as per this, who guided how to use this oil? So there is a society, SAE. SAE stands for Society of Automotive Engineers. Society of Automotive Engineers. By this, they given grade to the oil. For example, grade given to the oil. I will show here. See, here you will find 20W-40 on this oil, or one more oil, 10W-40. You are looking, and here is a picture of two wheeler, 10W-40. What is it actually? So, for example, here 10W-40, in this way it is written. So this W stands or used for winter. Why winter? Because in a cold climate, okay, cold climate, oil is becomes semi-solid, you know, parachute oil in a winter because of low temperature, that becomes thick. And if oil becomes thick, normally in a winter we face the difficulty of starting the vehicle, cold start, vehicle is not getting started because it increases resistance because of high viscosity. So that is why oil should have low viscosity while starting. And when that oil come in a operation, it should sustain under the temperature. For high temperature, that oil should become thick, or that oil should not go beyond the limit of thin oil, because very thin oil will vaporize. That is why oil should remain a particular thin nature, and at the start oil should not remain in a thick nature. For that purpose, that oil is experimentally tested between the range low temperature to high temperature, and in that way this number is given. This is a viscosity number which is measured at low temperature, and this is the viscosity measured at the high temperature. Low temperature is considered as a -22°C. High temperature is considered as a 100°C of the oil experimentally conducted. And for this span, -20 to 100°C, then grading is given like this, 10W-40, then 15W-50, likewise. So here I will maintain some categories. For example, see, first oil, this number is increasing. So 40 number we can use for bike, for 50 number we can use for car, and 60 number we can use for truck. I think you understood. See, 40, low duty, medium duty, high duty, heavy trucks, buses, number is higher. Bike, small duty, number is lower. So lower to higher. In that way, SAE has suggested to use the oil. So according to that, we have to purchase or we have to use oils in the application for the two-wheeler, for the four-wheeler or for the truck. Understood?
So at the end of this session, you can explain theory of viscosity, construction of redwood viscometer, experimental procedure, observations and sample calculations, and results and discussion with practical relevance. Subscribe the channel Thermal Engineering for further video sessions. Thank you.